بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم اما بعد my dear respected brothers elders and youngsters and sisters السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته inshallah tonight we will be reciting the 14th juz followed by surah al-hijr and surah al-nahl in this juz of quran we cover two chapters today as I mentioned the rocky tract and the bee the first of these two was revealed at the time when persecution was at its peak in Makkah Mukarramah, when Islam was making its gateway, when Islam was spreading more and more. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns the pagan Arabs of the fate of earlier nations who have come into opposition of the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the messengers who brought the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and who directly challenged the oneness and the qudrat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who is Allah? What is Allah? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling and reminding the Arab pagans that remember what has happened to your forefathers or your ancestors or who were following your footsteps and they are no more. So learn from them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in this surah by way of further warning that this is the last warning. Understand. Allah highlights how shaitan is persistent on corrupting people while the Prophet is consoled and instructed to hold fast to truth and to be patient and steadfast. Ultimately, the truth is matter which is protected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will always protect the ones who are on haqq. The chapter of bee takes its title from the mention of bees from which honey is produced. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the surah that honey fihi shifa'un linnas, that it is a cure for the entire mankind. And it's the creation, the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created this bee and its wondrous miracles, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in verse number 68. I would request everyone at home to look at this entire surah, what the bee is all about, and the miracles of the bee, and why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned it specifically. And also in the end, it is highlighting the blessings, endless blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the bounties which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to his creation. So what do we learn from tonight's recitation? Number one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comforts Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam of the great hardships being given to him by the non-believers. Number two, the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam, Lut alayhi salatu wasalam, and the people of Al-Hijr, the rocky tract. Number three, Surah An-Nahl, the bee, is also called the chapter of blessings also, because Allah is mentioning His tremendous bounties and blessings on mankind in this chapter. Number four, it contains many proofs showing that Allah alone is to be worshipped. And finally, the chapter ends by encouraging man to call Allah with wisdom and goodly exhortation and be patient in the face of any harm and oppression that comes in his way. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me and give us all the tawfiq to act upon whatever we have heard. Jazakallahu khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.